Here I'll show you how to make a square booklet. You can see that it has a cover and the inside pages are white. To make this booklet, we're going to need a pair of scissors and a square sheet of paper that has a pattern on one side and is white on the other. With the white side up, we're going to fold this in half to make a rectangle. And we'll give that a crease and then unfold, and we'll rotate this and fold it in half again to make another rectangle from the other direction. Now we're going to unfold this so that the white side is exposed. And we're going to take the top and fold it down to that middle crease that we've previously made. Okay, once we've got that folded and creased, we're going to flip this over. Now we're going to take the bottom edge of our paper and fold it into the middle crease. Okay, from here we're going to take the right and left hand sides and fold them into this vertical middle crease here. Now we're going to take this inside corner here and fold it down to the outer edge, just like this, and give that a good crease, and of course we'll do it on the other side as well. Now this next step is a little tricky to explain, so just take a look and see what I do. Basically, I took the colored flap on top and tucked it behind the white edge on the bottom. Let's see that again on the other side. We're going to take this flap and tuck it behind the top flap. Okay, once you do that, make sure you take a second to recrease all your lines and make sure things are flat. Okay, now we're going to use our scissors to make a few cuts. We're going to cut right here in the middle line, and we're going to cut these edges here and here on the left and right side. Okay, by now I'm sure you've guessed that these white pieces of paper on the bottom are going to be our pages, but we need to put them inside the book. So we're going to take this flap, fold up, and then bend backwards on itself to the right. Give that a good crease, and now we'll do the same thing on the other side. Fold up, and fold backwards on itself, this time to the left. Okay, and that's pretty much it. That's our book. Now, my book is a little thick and tough to close because I use scrapbook paper, which is more like cardstock. But if you use regular origami paper, or even office paper cut to a square, you shouldn't have a problem. And there's your square booklet.